Well, hi everyone, Juliet here. And in this video, I want to discuss the purpose of taking your BBT or your basal body temperature and why it's such a valuable thing to do when you're trying to conceive, especially if you're having difficulty getting pregnant or you're in the process of undergoing some fertility investigation. So I want to start off by explaining what exactly your BBT is and why you would want to record it. So your BBT is your core resting temperature or your waking temperature. And the idea is that you take it as you wake in the morning or after your longest period of sleep. Now the reason that we record BBT is that you can use it to identify if you've ovulated and when you've ovulated. So your BBT is basically going to be at two different levels during your menstrual cycle. So before you ovulate or before you release an egg from your ovaries, you'll find that your temperature will fluctuate up and down in a lower range. And then after you've ovulated, so after you've released an egg, your temperature will fluctuate up and down in a higher range. And the reason that it does that is because of a hormone called progesterone. So when you ovulate, after you ovulate, your ovaries will start secreting this hormone called progesterone, and it's a heat-generating hormone. So once it starts going into your bloodstream, what it does is it causes your temperature to become elevated. And that's why your temperature will go up after ovulation. And once it goes up, it will then stay up right the way through until you get your next period. So why do we record BBT? What can we do with that information? Firstly, by recording your BBT, you can figure out if you're ovulating. Now, obviously, if you're trying to get pregnant, knowing whether you're ovulating or not is really, really important. If you're not releasing eggs or not releasing them regularly, then of course they're not available for fertilization and you can't get pregnant. And this is especially valuable for women who've got very long cycles or erratic cycles, especially women with PCOS or polycystic ovary syndrome, because those long erratic cycles are often a symptom that you're either not ovulating or you're not ovulating regularly. So it's nice to confirm that you are actually releasing eggs on a regular basis. Then just as importantly, taking your BBT helps you know when you've ovulated or the day that you've ovulated. And this aspect of taking your BBT is really, really important, especially if you're having difficulty getting pregnant. And that's because it helps give you some really valuable information. Firstly, it helps you identify if you've timed intercourse correctly. Now, obviously, if you're not timing intercourse for your fertile window or those fertile days when you're actually able to conceive, you're not going to be able to get pregnant. So your most fertile time or fertile days each cycle are the 2 to 3 days before ovulation. So by figuring out the day that you've ovulated on, you can look back retrospectively, check that you did time intercourse during that time, and know whether you've got a chance at pregnancy or not. Secondly, your BBT helps you check if the length of your luteal phase is a good, healthy number of days. Now, the luteal phase of your cycle is the time between the day that you ovulate and the day that you get your next period. It's a really critical time in the menstrual cycle, and it needs to be at least 10 days long for an ongoing pregnancy to occur. So a short luteal phase, a phase that's shorter than 10 days, can prevent pregnancy and cause early miscarriage. So checking the length of your luteal phase is really easy once you know the day that you've ovulated on. If you do have a short luteal phase, that's one type of luteal phase defect. It is treatable, and I will be doing a video for you on luteal phase defects. The next valuable piece of information that you'll get from knowing the day that you ovulated is that you can figure out the day that your period or that your next period is actually due. So that luteal phase that I was talking about is a set number of days within one individual woman. So you'll find that once you've ovulated, you'll have a set number of days until you get your next period. So the nice thing about that is you can have a look on your temperature chart or your fertility chart, figure out the day you've ovulated, count forward your set number of days that your luteal phase normally is, and you'll know what day your period is genuinely due. That's really good for women who've got quite erratic cycles or irregular cycles. And obviously, if your period doesn't come when it's due, that's a really good indicator that it's time to do a pregnancy test. And as an extension to that, taking your BBT and knowing the day that you ovulated on can also help you figure out if you might be having early miscarriages. Now, some of you may have had the situation where your period has taken a long time to come, or it's been well overdue before you get your period, or you might have had some symptoms that you've suspected might be pregnancy symptoms, but then you've ultimately got your period, and you might have thought, well, did I have an early miscarriage? Did I actually get pregnant? So again, by using your BBT and figuring out the day you've ovulated on, you can first of all know when your period is due, and then if your luteal phase gets longer than the number of days that it normally is for you, particularly if it gets up to 18 days or more, and then you have a bleed, that's a good sign that you may have had an early miscarriage. And then finally, by knowing the day that you've ovulated on, you can make sure that if your doctor orders a progesterone blood test, you get that done on the right day of your cycle. It's going to give you an accurate result. So the progesterone blood test is a test, it's one of the first tests that a doctor will typically order for you if you want to get some fertility investigation done. And it's designed to determine if you've ovulated or whether you're ovulating. Now, if you're taking your temperature, you don't need to know that. Your temperature will normally tell you whether you're ovulating or not, but doctors like to have that information in the form of a blood test. But it's really critical that when you are getting the progesterone blood test done or having your blood taken, it's done 7 days after ovulation. If you get your blood taken significantly earlier or later than that, the blood test results can come back showing that you're not ovulating. And I've had numerous clients who have come to me very, very upset telling me that their doctor has said they're not ovulating. And when we chart their fertility and they take their BBT, we can clearly see that they are ovulating, but it's happening much earlier or later than the doctor has assumed. And so that blood test has been done on the wrong day. So that's another great bit of information that you can get from knowing the day that you've ovulated through charting your BBT. So if you're having difficulty getting pregnant, this is all great information to take to your doctor, because it can help him or her decide what the next best steps are for you with regards to treatment. And taking your BBT can also help you feel more in touch with your body and more in touch with your menstrual cycle. And it can take some of the stress and the guesswork out of trying to conceive. So that's the purpose of taking your BBT, and it's why I believe it's such a valuable thing to do when you're trying to get pregnant, especially if you're having difficulty conceiving. It is really important, though, that if you are going to take your BBT, that you do know how to take your BBT correctly, and even more importantly, how to interpret the information that you're seeing and what to do about it. And I will make you some videos on that, but in the meantime, if you're interested in charting your temperature and your other fertility signs, my online program covers all of that in detail. So I hope you found this helpful, and I look forward to seeing you soon.